Hey everyone, today I want to share with you this website that I made for Amber, a mindfulness meditation teacher that I actually met here on YouTube. I'm going to be showing you my whole process of designing the brand, planning out the wireframes, and building out the website in Squarespace. But first, if you're new here, hi, I'm Jen. I am a freelance web designer and artist. While I still have you here, I would love for you to help a fellow human out and give this video a like. It's free and quick and easy, and it really helps me out. Okay, let's get into it.
So starting out, she had some specific ideas about how she wanted the branding to look and feel. She gave me some websites and logos that she really liked as inspiration. As a mindfulness meditation teacher, of course, we were looking for a calm and serene presence, clean and minimal and uncluttered with muted colors. To be honest, this in itself was a challenge for me because I always tend towards brighter, colorful, fun designs. And this was calm, serene, minimal, so kind of the opposite of my normal vibe, but it was a good challenge for me. Another idea she had mentioned was that she wanted the logo to feel handwritten, more of like a note scrawled on a napkin feel rather than like bridal shower calligraphy. Since meditation is very internal and intangible, she thought that the feel of something that you could physically hold in your hand, like a handwritten note, would also help in grounding the brand. I found a few handwritten fonts that I thought matched the criteria, but eventually she did end up finding one that she liked better that seemed a little more hand scrawly than these ones. And so you'll see the logo switch over to that other version at some point in the video, but at this point we were still going with this particular font for the logo. In addition to the logo font, I decided to use the Baskerville font family for the rest of the text on the website. Because whenever I see the Baskerville font, I just immediately think of books or like novels. Seeing this text on a creamy white background just feels like I'm reading a novel. And so I felt like it really captured that tangible groundedness that she was going for. I also came up with an alternative branding concept that was different from the direction that she had given, just to give her another option to choose from. With this second brand concept, I wanted to deliver something more clean and modern, but still kind of warm and inviting. But she did end up loving the first brand concept, so we went with that one. Next, I started working on the wireframes for some of the main pages. I'm using an app called Figma here. So with the wireframes, the idea is to plan out like a blueprint of the page, thinking about the website strategy and how we want the page to flow before we start adding in more visual details. It's kind of like in art when you do a rough sketch before you start like painting or adding the color. So once I finished the outline of the homepage and the main sales pages, which are kind of like the most complex pages, I took the homepage outline and I added in more detail and turned it into a more high fidelity design mockup. And the reason why I do this here in Figma instead of going directly into Squarespace is because it's so much easier for me to brainstorm and iterate on the design here in Figma, just like copying and pasting the whole thing and changing things around, than it is to do that kind of work in Squarespace. So I only like to design the homepage or the landing page in Figma because it is usually the most complex page in the website. And I feel like once I have the style down for the homepage, I can kind of just reference that as I'm building out all of the other pages in Squarespace. So after I took this design and built it out in Squarespace, I then continued to build out the rest of the pages. I just wanted to mention, I don't necessarily recommend this approach of designing first and then building it out in Squarespace if you are a beginner just trying to DIY your own website, because Figma is kind of just an open sandbox. You can design things however you want, but then when you try to put that into Squarespace, there are like constraints and limitations on where things can go and how they look. So you have to be really familiar with Squarespace and know CSS to get things looking exactly how you want them. So if you are a beginner just trying to make your own website, I would suggest just starting directly in Squarespace. I just wanted to share my approach. Like, this is just what works for me, but do whatever is easiest for you. So after I build out all the pages in Squarespace, I will then adjust the mobile versions of each of the pages. In the Squarespace editor, when you're in the mobile view, you can change the size of things and move them around without affecting the desktop version of the website. But if you change any of these settings in the little pop-up, then those settings will carry over to the desktop version too. for the most part. So these settings are more like global settings applied to both mobile and desktop versions. So you need to be careful and just make sure whenever you change the mobile version, always double check that the desktop version still looks okay. So this is the final version of the website. This is the homepage. We have a section here highlighting her main offering. Scrolling down, we have a lead magnet and another one of her offerings here. We have a section about her and then a newsletter sign up. This is the sales page for her course, which is her main offering. So it's one of the more important pages. We have a section here highlighting some of the target audience's main problems and how this program aims to fix them. We have a testimonial section with some quick videos. We have more detailed information about the course curriculum, an about section to connect her with the audience and show why she's a good fit to teach the course. Another testimonial section for more social proof. We have an FAQ section towards the bottom for any lingering questions. And then we have a final call to action section, as well as a secondary call to action if they are still hesitant to buy. So another cool thing we did was we added a video gallery page to her website. So she already has a lot of videos up on YouTube of like free meditations, but we're adding them here in a gallery just to give her website a little more SEO. This will just like better optimize her website for search engines and add more text with potential keywords that people could search for and end up on her website. We also added an about page. And we have a contact page. We have a couple of her other offerings, which are essentially just sign-up pages, like lead magnet pages. Yeah, so that is the website.
Let me know what you think of this website in the comments below. If you have any design feedback, I would love to hear it. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!